With multitask turning centers becoming more popular, Mastercam 2024 has made some significant improvements to the B-axis contour toolpath. If you're new to the turning side of things, when referencing the B-axis, we're talking about the rotation of the mill turn's milling head that enables it to perform work on various angles of the part, both on the main or subspindle. Let's take a look at our bell housing signature part and dive into it. We will turn section view on to get a better understanding of what we're looking at. For reference, the diameter being held in our jaws is around 8.5 inches. The first improvement we will cover is the addition of the adjust stock function. Built into many other turning operations already, it has now been included in the B-axis contour turning operation. The interface has been completely redesigned for an easier workflow. Let's take a look at toolpath number one on our part. When we backplot the toolpath, we can see the tool is feeding into the stock at the beginning of the cut, respecting the stock area boundary. In the toolpath parameters, we can navigate to the Stock tab and click the Adjust Stock button to edit the stock at the beginning and end of the toolpath. This will control how the tool enters and exits the material. When we click the button, Mastercam displays the existing remaining stock relative to the chain geometry. This green ball indicates the beginning of the chain, while the red ball indicates the end. The gray dashed line indicates the current stock boundary. The white dots appear and allow us to snap to a location. We can use the dot which is parallel to the direction of the cut to extend the stock to the face of the part, or we can use the dot parallel to the direction of the chain to create a chamfer. While we're here, we can update the end of the toolpath as well. We can hit enter and regenerate the toolpath. Let's backplot and see the results. The tool now starts off the part since we have designated additional stock to be removed. The neat thing about the B-axis contour toolpath is that it isn't specifically a face, ID, or OD toolpath. Since the beginning of the cut doesn't necessarily have the same cut direction as the end of the cut, the toolpath doesn't use the same algorithms for entry and exit motion as other turning toolpaths. Back to our bell housing part. Let's rechain toolpath number one and include the face of the part as well. We will be sure to adjust our lead-in direction since we have changed the cut direction. Let's regenerate and see what the toolpath looks like. This toolpath looks good, but let's take a closer look at the angle of the tool when cutting the major diameter of the threads. We can see the tool is tilted at a steep angle, about 20 degrees in this spot. Let's adjust where the insert is contacting the part. Mastercam 2024 now lets us manually define a usable portion of the cutting insert inside the toolpath parameters. Rather than entering a dimension, we can visually designate the section of the insert that we would like to use. We will go into the toolpath parameters and head to the Advanced Motion Control tab. At the bottom, we can see the Maximum Insert Depth section with an option for manual. Mastercam returns us to the graphics window where we can edit the boundaries of the usable portion. We can use our mouse to drag each colored ball to the desired location of the insert boundary. We will hit enter to return us to the parameters page. A new preview button has been added to show the updated insert boundary in the graphics window. This can be used no matter what method we use to define the usable insert area. The display takes into account the holder clearance value as well. For collision checking purposes, the unused portion of the insert is treated like it's part of the holder. We can regenerate our toolpath. We can see the tool is at a lesser angle, which should give us great tool life and great surface finish. If you're a B-axis contour power user, you're probably familiar with manually creating and selecting tool vector lines for your tool axis control. This is a powerful way to control the tool and gives us the ability to designate our B-axis angles at any given point along the chain geometry. It works great, but requires some time creating and editing geometry before we even get into the toolpath itself. Now for Mastercam 2024, we can adjust, add, or delete our tool vectors after the toolpath has been created. Let's take a look at how it works. We will look at toolpath number 2. It's set to automatic tool axis control, and it looks pretty good, but we can fine-tune some of the steep areas. We need to open the parameters and head to the basic motion control page. We will pick modified as our tool axis control strategy. Mastercam displays the current tool axis vector in the graphics window. We can click on a vector and use the angle dial to rotate it to the desired orientation. Press the shift key to display an outline of the tool along with the vector. While we are editing the vectors, the tool rotation is stopped if a collision is detected or if it hits the travel limit. We can double click on the chain section to add a vector, or select an arrow and click delete on our keyboard to remove it. We can press enter to return to the function panel. Mastercam does not edit the original wireframe geometry that was used to create the initial tool axis vector. We can regenerate and backplot the toolpath. The motion looks a lot better, and we didn't have to create any manual lines. These features give us even more control of our B axis, with the goal of improving tool life and optimizing surface finish.